So we're going to have a tea party set up here later again. So spirits, if you're hearing me, and the spirits that sat with me last time.
Hey there, everybody. Thanks for taking the time to watch another spiritual warfare series here on Daily Inspiration, and hopefully you'll learn something new by the end of this video. Anyway, I'll kick off this video with this scene from the Russell Crowe's movie, The Pope's Exorcist. And as you can see from this clip, apparently, he was having a friendly conversation with the demon who was possessing the kid in the movie.
Whatever you do, you only do because God allows it.
Did he allow that? This is just the beginning. You don't know who you're dealing with.
Then tell me. Tell me your name, unless you are too afraid.
I'm not some stupid fuck you convinced to get into a pig.
So you won't tell me your name?
My name is Blasphemy. My name is Nightmare.
My nightmare is France winning the World Cup.
You prideful fool. You can't hide behind your jokes forever.
Now I've watched a lot of lectures and interviews of real-life exorcists before, and they kept on saying that they would not be having conversation with the demons during exorcism like what Russell Crowe was doing in the movie. They would force the demons to answer their questions during exorcisms, but to be having conversation is really out of the question because, as we know, the devil is the father of lies, and this is why we have been repeatedly warned against talking to Satan.
But if this video gets 21,000 likes, I'm shooting very high. That is not going to happen. But if you somehow make that happen, we will come back.
Bro, it sounded like someone was just like blowing me kisses in my ears. Listen. I'm here.
Oh.
Amazed.
Okay, spirits, you're here.
It's me.
As Monsignor Stephen Rossetti once wrote, if we start talking to Satan, we are lost because he is more intelligent than us. Satan is the father of lies and a master manipulator of the human psyche, and this is why exorcists are told not to address Satan directly, except to tell him to leave. During exorcisms, the exorcists may command the demons to say their names, how they entered, when they will leave, and any other information directly related to the mission of casting the demons out, and that's it, no more than that. But Monsignor Rossetti shared one particular mistake he made during an exorcism in his writing. During the exorcism, the demon said he was Lucifer, and later the name Satan surfaced. Monsignor Rossetti commanded him, "Are they the same entity?" And the response he got was, "They are the same." He was then reminded of something he had read before. Father Gabriel Amorth, the famous exorcist of Rome, had said he thought they were two different entities. So Monsignor Rossetti said as much. Father Amorth said they are two different beings, and this was the mistake. He had veered into an area of curiosity which, in this case, is a low-level sin of pride. This gave the demons an opening, and they jumped at it. For the next 24 hours, Monsignor Rossetti was pummeled with demonic obsessions in his head, all sorts of wild temptations and attacks, but fortunately, with repentance and prayer, it finally stopped. That is why we are warned against talking to Satan, not only because Satan will outweed us, but also it will give him an opening into our heads. Being pummeled by demonic obsessions is no fun at best, and at worst, it can lead to dire consequences. Before I end this video, I'd like to share something that I found on YouTube. Apparently, these two are simply writing on the back of their encounter with the demonic for views. I mean, just take a look at this, having tea with the demons.
So we're going to have a tea party set up here later again. So spirits, if you're hearing me, and the spirits that sat with me last time, we'd like to...
Frank.
Okay. It must have been Frank then who scared the ever-living hell out of me.
The spirit of Frank?
Yeah. So, alrighty. Well, we'll be back. Let's get this night started.
Now don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to shame people publicly, but someone needs to tell these people that what they're doing is really dangerous. And here's another thing that bugs me with these so-called Ghostbusters or whatever. They've been in the presence of evil and even see something with their own eyes that couldn't be explained scientifically, and yet they still refuse to acknowledge that God exists. I'll just leave you guys with that, because until this day, this really bothers me. Why would anyone do these things unto themselves?